So today I'm going to show you how to configure Office 365. So as you can see here, I got an email as an invitation to Office 365. So when you click on this link, you'll be brought to a website that looks like this. So as you see, it's a plan P1 trial for 30 days with 10 user limit. So we'll go next. So now here you'll fill out this invitation, and I'll do that real quick. So as you can see here, I filled out all of the information. Make sure you get your email address, your phone number, and your business address. Also, make sure to come up with a domain name. If you already have a domain name that you're using for email, you can use that also, but you need to come up with this first. So once you're done with that, click Check Availability, and then come up with a user. Also, it won't let you finish registering until you have a strong password. So once you filled out the caption, got your password and username, click I accept and continue. Now you have to select your region. This is very important because Microsoft is bound by a lot of different laws in different areas, and they make sure that your traffic doesn't go through another country. So, United States, and once you get your email address, click Save and Continue. So for this part of the video, I'm going to show you the admin panel. So this is what you see when you log in as an administrator. Up here you can go to your Outlook or your team site, which is SharePoint. So right now we're going to go to Management Users. So this is where you'll add all of your users. So let's say that I want to add a user. If you've already set up your personal domain option, then you'll click this one. But for right now, I'm just going to use the on Microsoft address. So click Next. So we're going to add our user. We're going to add Testy Testerson. Is the username is going to be testy at your business at onmicrosoft.com. Now here you can add him as an administrator or not. Again, you have to choose your location, so we're going to add him to the US. And then this is where you can assign licenses. So if you just want him to be an administrator and not have a license, you can just uncheck it. Or say you don't want him to have Link or SharePoint access, and Exchange's email. So in this case, we're going to give him all of the permissions. Now you can send an email. So this is where the email with his password and account information is going to go to. So we're going to go ahead and send that email. So the user was created. You can see here that it also creates a temporary password and shows it to you. So you don't necessarily have to email it. Click Finish. And that's it. So now we have our other user. And from here we can reset his password. We can edit him. So you have the ability to change other things. You can block sign in. Add more information if you want. And you can change it to your personal domain at a later time if you want. Then you can configure Outlook and Link settings there also. So next I'm going to show you how to do a catch-all. So Microsoft Office 365 doesn't let you have all of the emails that don't have an actual address to go to a specific mailbox. So if you wanted to have Testy catch other emails. So we'll go into Change Mailbox Settings. Go down to Email Options, and here you can add other addresses. So say I want him to get the support emails and the help emails. Then just make sure to click down here at Save, and that's it. Now when he is in his Outlook, he'll get the support, help, and his email. And I think that's going to wrap it up for today. Thank you.